am I here to define a woman? No, that would be completely foolish of me. As Oscar Wilde has rightly said, only the shallow know themselves. And to try to understand a woman would be like swimming in the deepest of the waters without protective gear. And I swim so badly that I may even drown in the Dead Sea. I am here only to shower gratitude on some of the women who have directly or indirectly touched my life. Having sacrificed my long-held dream of becoming a medical doctor, I was in mourning. My second ambition of retaining the title with a PhD also seemed to be all but doomed. At that time, my friend recommended a book called The Fountainhead. He also said that the author Ayn Rand was one of the most influential women of the 20th century. Having nothing much to do, I frantically flipped through the pages. I wish I could read the entire book to you. It has such powerful lines that it gave me a lot of confidence in the human will. And why not? Sample this. I don't make comparisons. I don't see myself in relation to anyone else. I refuse to measure myself as part of anything. I am an utter egotist. Having pandered to other people's wishes for over 2 decades, these lines gave me a fresh lease of life. The protagonist, Howard Roark's persona, filled me up with a lot of hope for myself. Isn't Ayn Rand the one who said, the question isn't about who is going to let me, it's who is going to stop me? Isn't this the spirit with which a young engineer, Sudha, wrote to the legend J.R.D. Tata, asking for women to be allowed on the Tata shop floor? When she read the newspaper ad, lady candidates need not apply. Did she ask her father's permission? Rand brought out a new wave of objectivism, while Sudha was the first among the many women to work on the Tata shop floor. Women not only change the system, but they also change the mindsets of generations to follow. Have you heard of Joan? Okay, who is she?
The only thing that I know about her is she was in the ancient time and she was burned alive.
No, if I give you her pen name.
Joan of Arc.
This is J-O-A-N-N-E. If I give you a pen name, you will start magically nodding your heads. Yes, someone said? Awesome. It is J.K. Rowling. So when I was in the broom cupboard of my life, much like Harry himself, my friends forced me to read Harry Potter, though I wasn't much into fantasy myself. But when I took up the book, each story was interwoven so perfectly, and some of the lines made my hair stand. This particular quote will remain with me as long as my faculties are intact. Happiness can be found in the darkest of times if one remembers to turn on the light. This line inspired me to turn on the light and be honest with myself. So I first admitted to myself and then my parents that I had to pursue a second degree, this time in commerce. It was not easy for me to admit to my parents that I could not stand the rigors of microbiology. It was not hunky-dory, but let me tell you that it is one of the best decisions I have made in life. J.K. Rowling might be a billionaire today, but there was one point where she was a nobody with 2 mouths to feed. She wrote in cafes and on the trains. She survived on unemployment funds. And now, she might be richer than the Queen. After multiple heartbreaking rejections, she finally found a backer in Bloomsbury House. She has beautifully put It is impossible to live one's life without failing at something. But only if you have lived so cautiously that you might not as well have lived at all, in which case you fail by default. All I want to tell you is that I am what I am today because of the women in my life. They may be my teachers, some of my friends and colleagues, my mentor at Toastmasters, DTM Kavya Gowda, and my supreme mentor of life, my mother. In fact, I would insist to my previous team girls that they call me a feminist. I am a self-confessed feminist, so they had to call me that. But all things said and done, who is a feminist? According to Gloria Steinem, a feminist is anyone who believes in full equality and humanity of men and women. And I said anyone. Feminism is beyond tokenism. So to that colleague of mine who coolly said, I am an equalist, I'm sorry. Feminism is equality in itself. It is very important for all of us to elevate the women to true equality. Yes, not all women and even men can achieve what the aforementioned great legends have achieved. So it is important for us to elevate them to true equality. Equality beyond intellectual arguments. Equality beyond speeches. And equality beyond cultures. Let us all take a pledge today to become feminists. Because to rephrase Emma Watson, if not us, who? If not now, when? I would like to leave you with this question. And wishing you all a very happy Women's Day to all the Madam Toastmasters and to all the women around the world. Toastmaster of the day, over to you.